Good morning, my dear children. Welcome to the online classes and welcome to our social studies. Okay, coming to the last topic, we discussed some of the important topics. Okay, coming to the recapitalization, first of all, we discussed about the denudation process, means processes like weathering, deposition, erosion, and transportations is responsible for the formation of landforms is called denudation process. And we discussed what is meant by weathering. Disintegration of the rocks through atmospheric forces or weather forces. Okay, when the rocks are exposed to the heat, then it expand. When the rocks are exposed to cold, again it will become contract. This expand contract, at last the rocks are ready to break. The water and the moisture also helps in this process. When the water reacts with the chemicals which are present in the rocks, then it weakens, rock will be ready to break. Okay, this process by which the rocks are weakened is called weathering. Coming to the next, we discussed about the erosion. Moving wind and water have a lot of energy. It can cut very hard rocks. The active wearing away of the earth surface by moving agents is called erosion. Which are called moving agents? Water and wind have the moving agents. Coming to the next, we discussed about the transportation. With the cutted material through the water and wind, small rocks, gravel, mud, soil, it can move from one place to the another places. Sometimes we go from hundreds of kilometers also. This is called transportation. Coming to the next, deposition. When the rivers and wind slow down, they do not have the power to carry from one place to the other place. That is why they deposited in the bed of the river. Then that is called the deposition. And also we discussed about the valleys. When a river comes with high forces to the down, it forms the V-shaped valleys. In the V-shaped valleys, we have narrow at the bottom and wide at the top. Similarly, when there is a hard rocks, it cuts a narrow valley and the sides are very steep. These are called gorges. Gorges have equal in width in the top as well as in the bottom. And also we discussed about the canyon. Okay, canyon have wide at the top, narrow at the bottom. Which is the biggest canyon in the world? Grand Canyon of Colorado in Venezuela. When the waterfalls will flow down, it will come with a great force and digs the under the rock and forms a small pool called the plunge pool. And also we discussed how the meanders are formed. When the riverbed has too high as a deposition of silt and sand, then when the floodwater came again, then it cuts with a new path and forms the new course. As this continuously changing, the meanders are formed like a snake-like structure. At last, in the meander, the loops comes closer to the closer and will break and forms a small lake called Oxbow Lake. Okay, up to this, we have completed successfully. Coming to the today topic, we will discuss about the work of glaciers. Very cold regions like the Himalayas and the Alps Mountain. Where is the Alps Mountains? We can find out in the Central Europe like France, Germany, Austria. We have the Alps Mountain. There we can get snowfall instead of rainfall. The snow will fall. Then whatever the snowfall will form and at last it will become hard and forms the ice. And slowly the ice is moving from one place to the another place, and when the ice will come in the warm area, then it will melt and start a small river. Similarly, like this only, in our India, the Ganga River was formed. Okay? The Ganga River was formed. By melting of ice only, the Ganga River was formed in Uttarakhand. Ganga River is formed of Gangotri Glacier. From the Gangotri Glacier only, Ganga River was formed. That is why the glaciers means slow movement of mass of ice is called glacier. Okay, what do you mean by glaciers? Glaciers means slow movement of mass of ice or river of ice. The glacier means a slow movement mass of ice, are also called river of ice is called glaciers. The glaciers will move very slowly, even few centimeters in a day or less only. The glaciers are moved because of gravity. Okay, very 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 important. The glaciers will move because of force of gravity. Okay, the glaciers will move because of force of gravity. This is the introduction of glaciers. What I told children, first of all I told, in the cold region like Himalayas and Alps mountains, which are present in Central Europe, they get the snowfall instead of the rainfall, and the snowfall will become the ice. When this ice is moving in a warm area, then it will become melting and forms a small river. But what is meant by glacier? Slow movement of ice means river of ice is called glaciers. The glaciers will move few centimeters in a day or less only. The glacier will move because of force of gravity. Similar like this only, our Ganga River was formed, which is our national river of India, Ganga River. Which is the longest flowing river? Ganga River. Where is the origin of Ganga? In the state of Uttarakhand. The glacier cuts everything by a process called plucking and transports the rocks from one place to the another place. You can see the sandpaper used by the carpenter to the wood. That will remove, when the sandpaper is using to the wood, it small particles will come out, taken out. Similarly, the glacier also erodes, cut the rock. Like a sandpaper only, the glacier will cut the bedrock. By this dual process, what are called dual processes, means abrasive and plucking, glaciers create a U-shaped valley. Abrasive means you can, by using sandpaper, if you do like this, then the small particles will come out. Similarly, the glaciers also continuously abrasive the rocks, and the process of plucking, it transforms from rock from one place to another place. The glaciers, through a process called plucking and abrasive, forms the U-shaped valleys. Very very important. Similarly the glacier acts as a abrasive. Means what is the meaning of abrasive? When the sandpaper is used to the wood, small particles will come, went out from the wood. Similarly, the glacier erodes abrasive from the bedrock. By this dual process, like plucking and abrasive, the glacier forms the U-shaped valleys. When the glaciers becomes water, it does not have the power to carry the large types of rocks from one place to the another place. Deposited there only. Then that are called moraines. Very very important. Moraines. As the glacier melts into water, it does not have the power to carry large types of rocks from one place to the another place. Then it deposited there only. Then that are called moraines and small particles like pebbles, means stones only, pebbles, sand will go, etc., go from one place to the another place. But the large rocks is deposited at the bed of the river only, that are called moraines. This is about the topic of work of glaciers. Okay, coming to the next topic, work of waves. We can see the waves which are coming with heavy forces in the sea. As the sea waves continuously hitting the rocks, first of all the cracks will develop in the rocks, and gradually hitting the rocks, sea waves are hitting the rocks with heavy force, and the hollow caves are formed. You can see the picture in your textbook. The strikes became bigger and bigger. Then we can see the roof of the rock, that are called sea arches. And after further complete of erosion, cutting, erosion of the rocks, at last the roof of the caves are lost and the walls only present, that are called stacks. And coming to the next, the steep rocks rising vertically from the sea water is called sea cliff. Steep rocks which are rising from the sea water vertically is called sea cliff. And you have to know about the difference between the cave and bay. Okay, cave is nothing but the land which are cutting into the sea. The land which are cutting into the sea is called cape. Example, Kanyakumari cape. Cape is nothing but the land cutting into the land cutting into the sea is called cape. Example, we can say Kanyakumari cape. Kanyakumari cape means Kanyakumari is cutting into the sea, is called cape. And come to the next, bay. Opposite of cape is bay, means okay, the sea. Bay means the sea cutting, the sea which are cutting widely towards the land. The sea cutting widely towards the land is called bay. Example, we can say Bay of Bengal. Bay of Bengal, which are present in the east of our India. This is the difference between cape and bay. And coming, this is about the topic of work of waves. First of all, what I told, due to the forces of the waves in the sea, it strongly hit the rocks and forms the hollow types rocks are formed. These are called sea caves. It gradually hitting and hitting, at last only the roof of the rocks are left. Then it is called sea arches. Again, after hitting the sea waves, after the erosion, cutting of the rocks, at last the roof is cut out and the walls only was left. This is called stacks. And next, the steep rocks which are rising vertically from the seawater is called sea cliff. And also I told about the difference between cape and bay. The land which are cutted, okay, the land cutting into the sea is called cape, Kanyakumari cape. The sea cutting towards the land part is called bay. Example, Bay of Bengal. Okay, the sea waves deposit sediments into the shores of the sea and forms the beaches. Just now we discussed about the work of waves. Coming to the next topic, work of wind. Up to now we discussed about the changes which has happened in the landforms due to the water. Now we will discuss about the changes which was happened in the land part by winds. You know, which is the largest desert in our world, Sahara Desert. In our India also we have the desert. What is the name of the desert? Thar Desert, which is located in the Rajasthan. almost 1/5. If you take the 5 part of the old world, if you take the 5 parts as a old world, one part we have the deserts only. In the deserts we have different types. In some areas we have the sandy deserts, in some areas we have the rock deserts, in some areas we have the stone deserts. Due to the strong winds in the desert areas, the sand will erode the rocks. Due to the force of the sand will cut the rocks, and we can see the different shapes which are formed by hitting the sand towards the rocks. Similarly, like a abrasive sandpaper and cut the hard rocks. Due to the strong winds in the deserts, the winds cut the lower section of the rock than the upper. And you can see the lower section of the rock is narrower and the higher section of the rock is wide. Similarly, that look like say mushroom only. That is why we can say that one as a mushroom rock. Coming to the next, Inselberg hills. Okay, these hills are formed isolated, which are coming suddenly from the ground. It's called Inselberg, or we can call or island. Mountain. We can see in the top of the Inselberg hills, we have round shaped, and from the sides of the Inselberg we have the steep slopes. What I told, okay, the deserts, due to the strong winds, the sand will hit the lower part of the rocks with a great force. When the strong winds will come, the sand hit the lower section of the rack, and the lower section will become narrow, and you can see the upper section is very wide, look like a mushroom only. Then we will call that as a mushroom rocks. And I told about the Inselberg. These are the isolated hills which are suddenly rising from the ground. In the top of the Inselberg we can see round shaped, and in the sides of the Inselberg we can see the steep slopes. Okay, coming to the next topic, sand dunes. Due to the process of weather and continuously hitting the winds, and we can find a large part of sand in many deserts. At last, this forms the sand dunes. Due to the weather and continuously hitting of the winds in the deserts, we can find a large part of sand that are called sand dunes. Okay, these are unstable hills. According to the wind, it will move from one place to another place. In that, we can see a large types of shapes according to the movement of the winds. This dust will blow and deposited in the neighboring of places of the deserts, and it is a yellow in color. Whatever the dust blow and go through the neighboring lands, actually what is the color of that one? Yellow color. And it was very fertile. It creates very fertile. Okay, this yellow in color, these are very fertile. This soil is called loess soil. Okay, yellow in color, these are very fertile. These are called loess soil. These are very rich in lime. Loam means onru bhumi. Loam, onru. We have a lime and we have a loam, and you can absorb the water very fast. But these plains are formed due to the deposition of loess, is called loess plains. Okay, what I told, dust which are blown and falls in the neighboring land, actually it is a yellow in color, and it is very fertile. This is called loess. We have very rich in lime and we have a loam also. Lime and loam weak. It is the soil will become very fertile. These plains are formed due to the loess. Then this is called loess plains. Okay, this is about the topic of sand dunes. And last, they given about the action of vegetation, human beings. Okay, you can know the impact of vegetation towards the rocks. Okay, vegetation means what? Which will come? Grass. Is plants. This vegetation helps in the process of weathering. Weathering means weakening of the rocks. When we have the cracks in the rocks, the roots of the plants will go towards the cracks of the rock. And water and moisture went through the roots of the plants, helps in the weathering process. You know, you are studied in the 6th class, vegetation helps to prevent the soil erosion. Vegetation helps to reduce the flow of water. The vegetation means grass, trees and plants helps in the weathering process. And I told how it helps in the weathering process. When the rocks, we can find out the cracks, then the roots of the plants will go into the cracks and the water and moisture enters into the cracks, helps in the process of weathering. And vegetation also prevents the soil erosion, and vegetation can reduce the flow of water. Coming to the human beings, now we are in the industrial world. First of all, which country is called workshop of the world? England. Okay, England is called workshop of the world. Because industry was started first of all in England only. Now we are in the industrial world. Okay, we are changing the crust of our earth. We are poisoning the soils. We are poisoning the water. We are poisoning the air due to the industries. Okay, this is about the topic. What I told, first what I told, work of glaciers, work of waves, work of wind, sand dunes, and last one, action of vegetation and human beings. Okay, the lesson was completed successfully. Hope you understood very well, and I will give the worksheet for you. Compulsory, all the people have to do the worksheet. Whatever I told, the important points you underline in the textbook, you read thoroughly. Okay, children, thank you. Next, we can go to the paper 2.